Joining me now from Brooklyn, New York, retired senior special agent with the Immigration and Naturalization Service, Michael Cutler. Michael, I consider this the Star Wars of immigration now, because we have aliens, literally, coming from galaxies far, far away to come to our border to try and claim asylum. Now, these are people from the Northern Triangle, but we're also hearing they're coming from Cuba and many other countries. I think now they've told us, the Border Patrol, now we're talking about dozens of countries represented from all these illegals that are at the border. How does this end, Michael?
Not well. And look, you know, the politicians who say there's no crisis, the first step to solving a problem is acknowledging there's a problem. So every politician who said this is a make-believe crisis wants what is happening. That's the only conclusion. And here's what's really the most disturbing, and I've written about this for Front Page magazine. Hezbollah, which is a client of Iran, it's a terrorist organization, is working in close coordination with the human traffickers and the drug smugglers to flood narcotics into the United States to hurt us as a way of raising money for terrorist activities. And here's the real danger: to allow their sleeper agents to have access to the United States so they could sit here and wait for the tap on the shoulder. Should things go further south between the United States and Iran, they are pre-positioned to carry out attacks in the United States. And several have been arrested, and one was just convicted earlier this week, a naturalized American. Think about that.
All right.
Educated. Our schools, and he's a sleeper agent.
All right, I want to get to the terrorists second, but first you brought up the drugs. McAllen, it's important to know what's going on down there. We talked just a couple of minutes ago about the people on the bridge. On one bridge, we have the illegals, Michael. On another bridge, drugs. 929 pounds of meth, Michael. 929 pounds of meth. That's $20 trillion street value. This is the perfect cover, right? All these illegals flooding our borders, a perfect cover for terrorists and drug runners.
And here's the other thing. If you look at McAllen, there was a story on television 2 weeks ago. McAllen has dedicated 40% of its Border Patrol agents not to line watch, but dealing with the aliens in custody. What does that mean? Our already sparsely defended border has roughly half as many agents now in certain areas to protect the border. This reminds me of the Calais deception that was the prelude to D-Day with Memorial Day coming up.
We understand that, you know, obviously these people are not being vetted. There's all kinds of disease rampant now. And, of course, you know, the Democrats are blaming the Trump administration for the spread of this disease. These people are not vetted. We don't know what kind of physical shape they're in, and it's a real problem. And now they know that they can come to the border in Texas and maybe get free airfare to California. I mean, this is craziness. And so we had the vice president of the Border Patrol Council on the program yesterday, Michael, and he said a stunning statement. Now, this is a guy who's in the Tucson sector. Again, he's the vice president of the Border Patrol Council, Art Del Cueto. Listen to what he said, Michael. Roll tape.
It's an invasion of our southern border. It's an invasion of our country. It has nothing to do with anyone's race.
No.
It has nothing to do with that. It's an invasion, and we need to start taking care of our country, because right now, I can tell you, and it sounds horrible, we have lost control of our southern border.
Lost control of the southern border, Michael. And so when you talk about the terrorists and Hezbollah coming to our border, this is a recipe for disaster. It's a recipe for another 9/11.
It absolutely is. And, you know, I gave testimony to the commission, 9/11 commission, that have arrested terrorists. How is it that nobody is talking about the 9/11 commission report, but we hear about more monuments, more memorials to people who died, people who were dying because of illness they got from 9/11? Open borders are a disaster for national security, public safety. And by the way, this business with the children that are with these families, the Justice Department or Homeland Security now say that at least 30% of these so-called families aren't families. They talk about children being rented. I think many of them have been kidnapped. And who do you kidnap? Children too young to interview. So there's no way of knowing who they really belong to. How do we return those children to their families back home, by the way?
And so the only way this is going to change, Michael, I only have 30 seconds left, but the only way this is going to change is if Congress does its job. And so the president proffers a portion of immigration reform. It's common sense. It's based on merit, which is a system we should go back to. But it's as if nobody listens.
No, and we're undermining the legal system. Why bother coming legally when you can come without documentation? That's what undocumented means. Unvettable. Could it be worse than that?
No. Well, I don't know. Knock on wood. I don't know. But I do know this, that the American people need to wake up and put pressure on Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer, the people from those districts, and realize what is at stake here, because the future of our republic is at stake. Michael, thank you.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.